हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, माई सेल्फ के एम झा, लेक्चरर VPMP पॉलिटेक्निक गांधीनगर। आई एम अगेन हियर विथ माई पार्ट टू। इट इज कंटिन्यूड पार्ट फ्रॉम द पार्ट वन ऑफ द नेम। टॉपिक नेम वॉज प्रैक्टिकल 12 एंड प्रैक्टिकल 13। देयर आई हैव ऑलरेडी टॉट यू रिगार्डिंग द प्रैक्टिकल 12 फ्रॉम द एडवांस जावा। नाउ वी विल सी द प्रैक्टिकल 13 एंड दैट्स वाई द नेम इज सेम एंड दिस इज पार्ट टू। फॉर प्रैक्टिकल 13 यू कैन रेफर दिस। The unit name is JDBC. This is unit 3 from the advanced Java. Now we will see the objective. After going through this, you people would be able to understand the practical 13 from your A Java subject. This we have already completed in the previous part 1 section, that is practical 12. Now we will see the practical 13. Aim of the practical is write a program to present a set of choice for user to select a product and display the price of product. It means we have to create here a list of product, and from there you need to click on any of the product. Once you click there, there should be an option or there should be a provision to display the price of product. Okay, and now we will go to NetBeans. For this, refer the continued part. Okay, now I am going to NetBeans. Here you will see, just a moment, A Java, this is source package, and here there are number of application that I have developed. This is your practical 13, that is stationery.java. Okay, first of all I need to give you the output, and once you get the output, it becomes easy for the student to understand the logical approach of this program. Okay, here run file. And you can see here, this is the output. Just focus on the output here. This is frame. Why it is frame? As you can get here, the title, that is product. Here you will get the minimize, maximize and close option. Okay. So this facility you are getting in frame only. And that's why this is the base. As a container, we are using the frame. Here, this grayish one. This is one. This is your another component that we kept over that. Okay. And this is only label. You can see here how we can understand it is a label, because once after clicking also nothing is going to change, and that's why it is a label. You can observe, I'm clicking here, but there is nothing is going to change there, and that's why it is a label. So I write the label as a selector product. Here I am going to click any of the product from the list. Once I click on the list, any of the product, you will see the output is displaying here in the text field. This is your text field. Okay, try to focus. This is text field. This was a static structure that I have already created. You can use the dynamic database also, and accordingly you can fetch the data from the database. This is static structure that I am using. Okay, so I hope ki the output is being understood by all of you. Now I am going to teach you regarding the practical 13. Just focus again. This is your frame. This is your label. This is your list. List as a component we use. And this is your text field where we are displaying the data. This data is actually already kept there. Okay. And from there it is going to be fetched. Just click here. For this, in frame we are using the close on exit function. Now, here. Here we have used the swing component. That's why you need to import the swing component, swing.star. And AWT is the mandatory part as it is the base. Okay, here I have used three components. The first one is label that I have shown you there, the grayish one. Then list is there. In list you kept number of product, scale, sharpener, then book, pen and pencil. So in list you are going to keep list of product, and that's why we use the component list. This is the object of that list. This is object of the label. We are using swing component, that's why J is also there. Text field where we are displaying the data. You might have observed in the base there was a text field where we were displaying the data. Okay, and this label was where we where I was keep on clicking. That was label, selector product. Okay, here we have used one array. Name of the array is name. There we kept list of things. This is static structure that I have told you. Already kept the data, books, pen, pencil, sharpener and scale inside the list. So for that I created a array having a name, having name of the array is in name. So this is static structure. We already kept the data, and what we are going to do this, we are going to keep this product inside the list that we will see here. Okay, this is your constructor. As name of the class is stationary, this is constructor. How we are actually executing this practical, I just want to tell you here. Whenever compiler start executing the program, it always searches for the main keyword here. Once it get the main keyword, start executing the program from here. We have created an object p1 by using this new operator exactly, and once object is created, the default constructor is called. The default constructor is stationary. You can see here this stationary, this one, the whole structure is going to be called by that object till here. Everything is going to be assigned to this particular object p1. As this is p1. P1 is a frame object. Why it is frame object? Because you can see here, stationary is an extended part of JFrame. It means p1 is frame. This is a container. Once it is created, on that container we are putting the another container, this one, container CP. We are putting another container over that, but base is your frame p1. And once it is created, all the things, whatever is going to be happen here, as the constructor is directly assigned to that object. Till here, whatever I am highlighting is everything is going to assign to that particular object. Okay, and we set the size of frame as 500 500. It is up to you can change the size also. Visibility we made true so that we can see that title is product that I have shown you there. On the frame there was a title, and I close the frame by using exit on close. For that it is compulsory to write that. Okay, now how the things are actually happening here, we have used the value change function. This is from the list. This is from the list class. Here we have used list class also. First of all, I just want to tell you how the things are actually executing there. So here you just focus on, this is about the operation get selected index. Please try to understand ki we are talking about list, and there is a function get selected index. It means ki once we are there in list, wherever we are clicking, as there is an index get selected index, wherever we are clicking, get that index and assign. From where we are getting that index? We are getting that index from the list and assigning that to the I variable. If that index is zero, then the price of the book is 100. Why index I is for book? Because here you have assigned, this is I0, this is I1, I2, this is I3, and this is I4. So it is already synchronized there. In array you kept the data from 0 to 4. Size of the array is here 5. For zero, if the index value is 0, if in the list you selected the first item, it means array's first index. It means in text box you are going to set the text. In text box, this is text field we have created here, this one we have created here. I have shown you in the output also, this is text field. If the index value is 0, then set the text. We are setting the text as the price of book is 100. If suppose I have clicked on the third object, that is pencil, it means I is equal to 2, then in the text field, please try to remember we are using the swing component, that's why we are using this J. Okay, yet it is not compulsory to use the same thing in the variables, but for the sake of convenience we are using this, but here it is mandatory as it is a class. Okay, so you are going to display the value. It is going to display the value 5. We are setting the text in the text field as 5. This is how the things are happening. Only up to the I4, index value 4, the things are going to happen. Then after, if, otherwise, else, set the text again. You go and select the item. Again, it is recycle. If you are not going to fetch any of the index, then again you go and select the same thing. It means it is a else part. Set text, select item. Okay. So this is how the things are going to be happen inside the list. How we are going to get this through the list. in the list we are having this inbuilt function get selected index, and this is how the things are executing here. Okay, now about this one. This is class stationary. This is constructor. As the name of the class is stationary, we are extending this. It means it is a frame we are going to implement in future. This is implements list selection listener. Why you just focus on the word list selection listener? I keep on repeating my words. Listener, listener means the thing which is going to listen. Listen means jo sunta hai. So once you click on the list, you are going to select anything from the list. It is a combo thing. It means multiple products are kept there. In list, list dekhiye na, there are multiple products are kept there. It means there is a listener attached to that. Okay, so in future we are going to implement a listener, and that's why the name in computer, I told every time ki the things are according to our day-to-day life. According to our day-to-day life, the things are kept there as a technical word. Okay, it is my personal opinion. So container that we are putting on the frame. Okay, we have created the object CP. Containers CP is there. How we are putting that CP? The layout is set as a border layout. You might be aware of border layout. There are 5 sections: center, north, east, west and south. So CP, it is a container, and this container, how we are setting that over the frame? In the form of border layout. We created the layout of container CP. CP is the object by using this new, and the layout is there, border layout. So layout, we have created the new one. We created the new layout for the CP. CP is a part of container. Okay, and that container that we are putting over the frame, that I have told you in the online class also when I was teaching this. So the layout you have created for that is border layout. Okay, now you are putting on that layout. On that layout means containers layout label. By using this new, you are creating this object JL1. This is L1. It means you are creating a label one, and there you have written select a product that I have shown you in the output. Okay, label is for displaying the datas or displaying the text, and that label you are putting in the north side of border layout. Where you are putting this label? You are putting that label on the containers object, because directly we cannot use any class. We are always creating an object. So CP is the object, and on that object we are putting the label in the north direction. Similarly, we created a new object list by using this new, and here you are using this name. The name that you have created here, it is a array, and you are assigning that list. You are assigning this list. Please try to see the focus on my movement of mouse. This name, this value is assigning to list. It means we are assigning this list of items to the list. Yes, and then we are putting this list on the CP. We are putting this list on the CP. Okay, also we are adding along with the list. This is list. We are adding add selection listener. This one we are adding there. This we are adding there. Okay, and then we are having text field, that also we are adding. That also we are adding on the container. That also we are adding on the container. And the whole thing of the container, we are directly assigning to the frame object P1. Okay, this is how the things are happening there. Please try to understand through yourself also. It is not that what approach I am using that you need to use. Again, I just want to tell you, this is how you will get the output. This is the output. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video. And kindly visit this if for further videos also. Thank you.